Hey guys, Moydog here, and today we're going to be going over the Rifleman class. The Rifleman is probably the most important, yet most overlooked class in the game. And the longer you play, the more you'll realize just how much more effective your squad is with a good Rifleman in it. I absolutely love this class, and for the first 20 hours or so that I played the game, I played this kit almost exclusively. And I think it's not only a good kit for experienced players, but I would strongly recommend brand new players to pick it as well. In this video, we'll not only go over the various weapons and kits you'll be using as Rifleman, but I'll also go over what I think are the best weapons to use depending on the faction you're currently playing, some tips on how to play the class when you're in a real game of squad, and a few tricks that may help you sneak up and catch the enemy off guard that only a Rifleman can do. But before that, I do want to remind everyone that I stream a lot of squad on Twitch, at twitch.tv/moydog. I squad lead, run vehicles, and play practically every kit in the game. So if you have any questions or simply want to watch some squad live, come hang out. Additionally, if you haven't picked up squad yet and do want to support the channel, check out my official game store at moydog.gg, where your purchase supports me directly. So, you've loaded up the game, joined a squad, and you're hovering your mouse over the role selection screen. You could choose a nice machine gun, or maybe have some fun with an RPG. So, why would we want to limit ourselves by just picking a Rifleman? Well, I'm here to say that the Rifleman is not only one of the most important classes in the game, but one of the most fun classes in the game to play, as you'll typically have the best selection of optics for your rifles, as well as the ability to constantly rearm and keep you and your team in the fight. Unlike a machine gun or marksman that may be restricted to one location, the flexibility of your rifle allows you to be effective at both long and close ranges, and you can even customize your loadout a bit depending on the map if you want to have more hipfire accuracy and close quarters capability, or take out targets at over 400 meters. Because of this, the first thing you should know when choosing your kit is that all riflemen are not created equal. For most factions, you'll have your base rifle, a choice of optics, and some grenades, but some factions will also allow a bit more freedom of choice, allowing you different weapons, different fire modes, and even an optional sidearm. Additionally, depending on what you select may also prevent you from using things like binoculars. So understanding the faction you're playing, the enemy faction you're up against, and the map you're currently playing on are all incredibly important when making your decision. We'll go over what I consider the best choice for factions and what map you're currently playing on later on in the video, but for now, let's get familiar with the kits themselves. The simplest way to discuss a Rifleman kit is to divide them into two different tiers, your close quarters kits and your long range kits. When selecting Rifleman, you'll notice that when you click the kit in the spawn selection, you'll see a drop down menu where you can select a specific weapon. Typically, these first two here are your close quarters weapons, with iron sights or another close range optic and full automatic capabilities. This kit will also give you two grenades and a pair of binoculars to help you see at longer distances that make up for the lack of the long range optic. The bottom one is your long range kit, and you'll get the best optic possible at the cost of one less magazine and only one grenade. Additionally, since you already have a 4x scope, you won't be getting binoculars. Generally, I would strongly recommend that if you're a new player, you should always select the long range kit, as it will help you acquire targets when you ADS. Squad is a difficult game to figure out where you're getting shot at first, but eventually you'll get the hang of it, and the Rifleman is, in my opinion, the best way to do it. Now, as we go over these kits, there are some highlights that I would like to point out, as although these factions are relatively the same when it comes to what the Rifleman is capable of, each faction does have their unique spin on the class. For the US, Rifleman 1 and 2 are not only two grenade kits, but they also give you the ability to fire full auto. This is a huge advantage at close range, as the ACOG M4A1 is restricted to semi and 3-round burst. Additionally, Rifleman 1 not only has fully automatic available, but you'll also be getting a foregrip, making it the most accurate hipfire rifle out of the three. Because of this, I rarely take the red dot optic when I'm American, and I think it's better to go iron sights foregrip for really close quarters maps like Kokan, Sumari, or Logar Valley. Although maps like Fallujah and Mutaha are urban, I would strongly suggest to keep the ACOG on maps like this, as it's incredibly useful to help find out which window the enemy is popping out from. The British kits are roughly the same as the American, however, all of the L85 rifles are fully automatic. If there's one thing I would like to point out about this faction is that, in my opinion, the SUSAT is quite possibly the worst optic in the game. The SUSAT is restricted to Rifleman 2, and I have had people mention that they absolutely love this sight, but I think it covers a bit too much of what you're trying to aim at, and I have a tendency to fire and move the scope left to right to see where the rounds hit. If possible, I always pick Rifleman 3 as the British, as this ACOG has no restriction on the full auto fire mode, and at close quarters, the bullpup is pretty easy to handle if you do need to hip fire. Many players have a tendency to ADS when they push buildings, but I would really like to stress just how accurate hip firing is in squad if you can get the hang of it. The L85 is also a perfect weapon for it, and I can honestly say that I don't think I've ever willingly chosen a kit that doesn't have the ACOG on it when I'm playing the British, even if I do have to sacrifice a grenade for it. As the Russians, you'll be equipped with the AK-74M. Rifleman 1 will give you the iron sights that can be ranged up to 1,000 meters, and if you do end up getting a kill at that range, I would absolutely love to see it. Rifleman 2 gets the 1P63, a Russian red dot equivalent. I'm not really a huge fan of the 1P63 since it can't be ranged, and I find myself misjudging the distance of targets really easily. The iron sights are fine if you do need two grenades, but like the British, I almost exclusively use the Rifleman 3 kit with the 1P63. 7.8 scope when I'm on Russian. Out of all the weapons in the game, the AK-74M with the 1P78 is my absolute favorite, and that's because the optic is not only really easy to use at all the different ranges, but the hipfire handling of the weapon is great too. It isn't as easy to handle as the M4A1 with foregrip or the bullpup, but I find myself tap firing and full autoing this thing all the time. If I'm Russian, I will gladly always sacrifice the extra grenade for the 1P78. It is just that good. The Middle Eastern Alliance, or MEA, use the G3A3s. Unlike all the other weapons we've seen, the G3 has only a 20-round magazine and has by far the worst kick. It is an extremely powerful rifle, however, and will two-shot enemy players no matter where you hit them. Whereas the other rifles we looked at require two torso shots, or one torso plus two limb shots to kill, the G3 can kill with one torso plus one limb shot, giving you a bit of room to work with. This can be incredibly deadly, as most experienced players can figure out where they're getting shot from and get behind cover after the second shot. And you'll notice that if you can learn the recoil, you'll probably have higher kill games with this rifle compared to others due to this shorter time to kill. I do have a love-hate relationship with the G3, and unlike the other rifles where I recommend you always use it full auto in close quarters, the fire rate and kick combined with a smaller magazine really makes this a bad idea. Putting the G3 on full auto without a bipod is incredibly inaccurate, and if you are forced to hip fire, I try to really keep this on semi. If I'm playing Rifleman as the MEA, I almost exclusively use the Z-Point, since although you can't range it for longer than 100 meters, I feel like it is a nice balance between close quarters and longer ranges that works really well with the G3. The ZF1 scope you get as the Rifleman 3 reminds me of a slightly improved SUSAT, and it really doesn't help you gauge distances as well as something as the 1P78 or ACOG. You can range it up to 600 meters, and I will choose this over the Z-Point on extremely open maps like Kohat or Talil Outskirts. Everything else, however, I use the Z-Point. Now that we've covered the quote-unquote normal rifleman kits, the following factions have slightly more unique takes which can make them really fun and interesting to play. Starting with Canada, you'll get the choice between either the C8A3 and EOTech with two grenades, or the C7A2 and C7982 optic with one grenade. Both weapons have semi and full auto fire modes, but the C8 does have slightly better handling. I really like Canada's choice of rifleman kits, and the C8 feels really fun to use. My main reason for using this over the C7 is that the C7's optic is ranged for 200 meters, whereas every other rifle in the game is ranged for 100 meters. I know at the root of it, it simply is a user error problem, but I have played so much squad with 100 meter ranged rifle optics that this slight difference has caused me to miss so many shots I would have otherwise made. To hit the target, you need a place where you want to shoot right above this marker in between the two horizontal indicators here. This seems self-explanatory, but oftentimes I absolutely whiff and find myself going back to the ammo crate and swapping to the EOTech sight, since you can still be decently accurate at long range and you will get that second grenade. For a regular militia, you have a variety of weapons to choose from as riflemen, the AK-74 with or without an optic, AKM, and M4. In addition to this selection, you will also receive a Makarov pistol as a sidearm, which is incredibly helpful if you're in close quarters and run out of ammo in your rifle, as swapping to your pistol is always faster. Another unique aspect of the militia's riflemen is that the AKM and M4 kits also receive sandbags, which allow you to fortify and hold a position outside of a fob. When deciding what riflemen to play as, I almost exclusively pick my rifle based on what faction I'm up against. If I'm playing against the US, I will select the M4, since although it doesn't have an optic, the sound of the M4 will oftentimes not tip off the enemy team that you're in the area. You do lose the fully automatic capabilities, but squad is very sound dependent. And if you're an American squad and you hear an AK firing from behind you, it's fairly straightforward to figure out that that's where the enemy is. If you use an M4, however, you can sneak in and disrupt the team, allowing your fire to mix in with theirs. I also tend to lean more towards the AK-74 when up against the Russians, as it sounds like the AK-74M. One thing that may surprise you, however, is the 1P29 scope, which is inverted. This may take some time getting used to, but I find it incredibly easy to shoot because the target itself is not obscured by anything, unlike the Suset. Finally, I do want to briefly go over the Insurgents, but I do want to say that this is based on the faction as they are in the game on release. The faction will be getting an overhaul, and it looks like they may be receiving the Mosin-Nagant rifle, which could either be a brand new marksman rifle, but we could also see the Iron Sight variant be included as a rifleman kit. If anything for the Insurgents do change for the rifleman class, I'll make sure to create a new video to go over them specifically. For now, however, every rifle that the Insurgents use has actually already been discussed, but I would caution when using the AKM, AKMS, or FAL, as they do have a lot of kick. On the close quarters maps like Sumari or Logar Valley, I like using the G3 or FAL, and almost every other map in game, I use the AKS-74 with 1P29 in order to help acquire targets and hit them at longer ranges. Like the militia, Insurgents also receive a pistol, so make sure to remember that if you do run out of ammo and you have contacts close. One thing I do want to say before we move on is that a lot of playing Rifleman is about being comfortable with the kit, and that ultimately comes down to your playstyle. For me, I tend to lean heavy on weapons that will allow me to close the gap and push a fortified area, like the M4 with a foregrip, or allow me to be accurate at not only long range, but give me the ability to flip the fire mode and clear a room, like the AK-74M with 1P78. It's ultimately up to you, so although I do strongly recommend a few weapons over others, really try to play around what works for your playstyle. Aside from the G3, FAL, and AKM, all weapons are 2-shot body shot kills and 3-shot other shot kills, so there's not too much metagaming like you would find in games like Call of Duty or Battlefield. Now that we know the weapons and what's best to use according to the situation, how do you actually be a better rifleman when you're in a live game of squad? As a rifleman, you are purely an infantry player. You're not anti-tank, you don't have healing capabilities, and you don't have fun things like mines and explosives. Your rifle is your best friend, and that's why I want to reiterate that you should pick the one that gives you the best rifle that fits your playstyle. In game, you'll find yourself in one of two roles, attack or support. When moving with a squad, you'll most likely be in the front pushing the objective since you'll want to try and protect your squad leader and medics. You'll also want to try and not push too far ahead, as you'll often find yourself as a lifeline keeping your squad in the fight. Although your rifle is your best friend, the ammo bag is really why your squad wants to keep you around. Your ammo bag holds 100 ammo, and with that, you can allow your anti-tank players to keep firing off rockets, your medics to keep reviving with more bandages, or resupplying everyone else with fresh mags if you're outside of a fob. Many squad leaders will typically put you in a fire team to follow around your anti-tank players, where you will pretty much try and protect them from other infantry and resupply with as much AT as possible. This can be fun, and you'll often find yourself wandering outside the wire with your anti-tank, trying to hunt down a vehicle, track him, and then destroy him. Additionally, one of the most important roles you play is being available for your squad leader to rearm their rally point. A rally costs 50 ammo, and since your squad can spawn indefinitely from a rally until it is destroyed by the enemy, it is crucial that your squad leader can deploy one at all times. If I find myself away from the fob or rally and see that there's some downtime, I'll ask if anyone needs ammo or if the SL needs to top off his rally. Try and manage your ammo bag carefully and tell everyone not to just press resupply all, as this can quickly drain your bag. In the graphic below, you can see a quick overview of some common items that people ask for resupply. So learn these numbers and try to keep track of your ammo at all times. Also, as a rifleman, understand that you are usually the player that will be picked to do the grunt work. You'll be building the habs, digging down the radios, and doing logi runs. Be a team player, and if a squad leader asks for something, offer to do it because you're the rifleman. I do want to say though, don't be constantly MIA from your squad the entire game because you think you have to drive logi non-stop. Every once in a while, I run into some awesome players who just want to help out by doing supply runs, but you're still an infantry player. And when we start getting in contact, a squad with a rifleman will be so much better off and more effective than one without. To wrap it up, I also want to go over a few tips and tricks that I use when playing that should help you in game. First, I would strongly suggest playing at a 90 field of view, as anything higher than 95 or so will make your optic look really, really small. I know some people like the greater FOV because you can see more in your left and right, but instead of increasing the FOV, I would instead take advantage of your free look. Hold Alt, and when running, I constantly use this to look around, and I also use it when ADSing to see things around me zoomed in as well. Additionally, if you are wondering why your sights might look fuzzy or transparent, it's probably your anti-aliasing settings. I like the look of my sights with AA on, but I've heard a lot of complaints about it, so you can either turn AA off or just try to get used to it. For gameplay, one tip that many people don't know is that if you reload immediately after respawning, you'll be able to fire off 31 rounds, since one will be in the chamber. This isn't critical, and very few times I force myself to do this, but in some firefights, especially at close range, that extra round can really save your life. Out of all the rifles, I would at least try and make this a habit for the G3 and FAL, since they are only 20 round magazines. If you're using a kit with binoculars, you can actually range targets for yourself or your squad if an observation mark from your squad leader isn't available, or you do want to get a quick and dirty distance. The horizontal line here indicates that these binos are ranged for targets 1.7 meters tall, which is about the size of a player. To range, simply put the bottom of the target at the horizontal line and find where the top of the helmet reaches. I don't typically use this for targets around 200 to 400 meters since it's easier to fire a round or two and adjust based on eyesight. But for times that I want to be sneaky and make my shot count, I like to range them. Although we discussed when to use full auto and semi-auto fire modes, it's important to know that if you want to shoot single shots, it's far more accurate to take the half a second to swap to semi instead of tap firing when you're on full auto. When trying to single fire full auto weapons, it tends to initiate the full auto mode even if you just tapped it once. This will mean that you'll shoot more than one round, and all of a sudden you'll have your weapon kick much more than you thought. I typically use middle mouse button to quickly swap between fire modes, and at all times I try to keep my rifle on semi. Only when I'm about to push into a building do I flip it on to full, and immediately after firing, I want to make sure I get it back to semi so I don't run into a problem later on. Finally, although your ammo bag is important for your teammates, it's also a great tool for you as well. Grenades are 10 ammo each, and sometimes I've found myself in positions where I can simply drop my ammo bag, toss a grenade, and repeat, essentially becoming a mini grenade launcher. For heavily defended positions or areas where the enemy has boarded themselves up, I like to take the chance of running right up next to the wall, dropping the ammo, and keep on sending frags over. One key thing though is to make sure you pick your ammo bag up afterwards so you don't lose it, since it's 100 ammo to rearm. Well, I think that just about covers everything you need to know to be an effective rifleman in squad. I think it's the most flexible kit in the game, and one of the reasons I love running squad leaders so much is because it's essentially a rifleman kit with a command radio. If you're a new player, you'll always be welcome in a squad as a rifleman, and by sticking with your team on defense and attack, riflemen will usually get to see most of the action. You'll also get a lot of chances to jump on emplacements like 50 cal bunkers and TOWs, as well as gun things like APCs and light vehicles. So really, embrace the kit and have fun with it. Learn how your squad moves around the map, keep an eye on teammates that may need ammo, and be proud of the fact that something as simple as staying alive next to a medic or your squad leader allowed your entire team to hold a position or take down a FOB. I think this covers just about everything you need to know when it comes to playing Rifleman. If I did miss anything you think is important or you have a question, drop me a comment below. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. I'd also like to give a huge thanks to my patrons who help support this channel and allow me to make guides like this. But that's it for me. Until next time, peace.
I wiped this. It was just like a three-man squad.